We have 2.5 minutes.
You can hear that. Yeah.
Two and a half minutes.
2.5 minutes, people.
Okay.
Who's the first? Chaos is the first.
Yeah.
So
guys,
the external.
I'm having a timer here.
Yes.
Which I will try to make visible as much as I can. But of course now I'm on the way. But you know.
How will you say? You point on.
Can everybody see the timer?
No.
You don't see 0:00?
I don't.
Oh, I would put it somewhere stable.
Yeah, but where? Because you also.
So there's also here, you also see the time.
Okay. And take your.
Yeah. Like that's
your
the. That it's like
to
the
communicate.
Timer.
To communicate,
it's
like.
It's like the time. That's like the time we have now.
Yeah.
Yes, yes.
Yeah.
So we will start at exactly 14.
Yes.
Sorry. Yeah,
yeah, we start exactly 14, and also to communicate is non-verbal communication.
Good.
Okay?
You can use your fingers.
You use your fingers.
That's good.
Attention, please. Is it attention,
oh,
please? If this is border.
Yes. Okay. I must always look here.
Yeah, and then, or if there is something, because Luis, she's going to be the one mixing, I mean, paying attention.
Mm-hmm.
she's going to be the one paying attention. And if you, if the sound, blah, 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 something, the sound, lower, louder, you know, if I tell you, you're on,
yeah.
And it's too loud, I do like that, right? And then we try to look at each other.
Yeah.
So this
yeah.
is 2 hours trip.
Yeah.
In a way, I would also like to know what microphone you're using. So maybe you can make some kind of sound, just like point at. Like, yeah, so
mm-hmm.
I. Because I will have my headphones on the
Give
whole time.
Priority.
Yeah. Yeah.
Space station is listening us. We have 50 seconds.
I'm also listening here.
He's a listener,
is
not? He's not. He doesn't want to be a threat.
No,
so
no, he's listening outside.
From outside.
Ah, okay.
Okay. Is it okay that I. Oh, we have 40
yes.
seconds?
Yes, right.
Okay. Okay.
Oh, and I have to change to this station. Oh, this is.
Oh, don't go to the toilet now.
That's pretty important. Or maybe somebody will do that for me.
Yeah.
Just,
no,
go
and
check.
Yeah.
Oh. Sorry.
20 seconds.
Sorry.
Yeah, it's okay. Calm down. Calm down.
Oh, it's now.
No.
10. 9.
8, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1,
now.
Hey, what are you? Where are you from? And how did you get here? Who do you belong to? Who did you belong to? And are you actually supposed to be here? Ich meine, in Hamburg, im Museum für Völkerkunde.
5% of all objects of the collection here in this exhibition.
The photo archives of the museum, they have about 70
so there's more
photos, which is also found by not yet high
to put colonialism into every text, I think, because it could disturb. But of course, we mentioned colonialism, that the homeland of the Hebrew became a German colony, but this is more about beauty concepts.
It's
but
called,
for example, this object, unfortunately, is one object of the objects in the colonialism.
You can,
and
if
there
you have Android, you can just download the app from the museum. Like there is a museum of
the
of
course, there are not so many objects. You don't really understand the picture. For example,
if
you just
see
a text about the colonial war in. With the Herero. And there's a there's one part of the exhibition is about Herero.
You don't you don't really understand the picture
if you just see it.
Concentration camps, skin and bone people, mass graves, medical experiments, and good German record keeping more than 30 years before the Jewish Holocaust.
archaischen Bilderschriften, was gesagt, das sind die Zeichen, die Bemalung und die Tattoos und diese Zeichen erklären das. Es gibt die Händler, es gibt Zeichen, die die Tiere markieren, es gibt Zeichen, die im Gesicht tätowiert sind und die ganze Lebensgeschichte erzählen. Und es gibt Zeichen, die zum Beispiel herausgefunden von Herrn Professor Dr. Karweide geschrieben, 1913 auf einer Buchausstellung vorgestellt. Petroglyphen, Steinzeichen. Und die Zeichen für viel Geld sind viele Ringe. Das Zeichen für heiße eheliche Liebe ist ein Stern mit einem Kreuzchen drin, also Doppelkreuz mit einem Stern drin. Ja, zwei Dreiecke, die sich abschneiden. Dann das Zeichen für einen Händler, der an einer Weggabel kommt, das Geld Manila, Spanisch, hufeisenförmig gebundene Kupferstangen. Das ist Geld. Hufeisen, Geld. Dann das Zeichen für ein Mann scheint sich auf seinen Magen zu gucken. Das ist einfach nur ein Strich mit einem Kuchen. Interessant, ein Zeichen. Thank you.
languages being a genitive. We have the orders, the letters, and the diaries. No doubt that the Germans meant to wipe out the Herero and Nama and take their land. It was not just a case of a general gone mad or a war gone wrong. General Lothar von Trotha, I believe that the nation as such should be annihilated or expelled from the country by imperative means. The Herero people must leave their land. If the populace does not do this, within the German borders, every Herero, with or without a gun, with or without a cattle, will be shot. I will no longer accept women and children. These are my words to Herero people.
Für die semantische Parallelisme, wo Kurt Wolf geschrieben hat, wir können wohl davon ausgehen, dass Lamang-Speicher in der Lage sind, für jedes der aufgezeichneten Opernspiele und darüber hinaus für jedes weitere Sprachkunstwerk ihres literarischen Repertoires eine Vielzahl von semantischen Parallelismen aufzeigen, aus denen sie die poetische Dimension der jeweiligen Texte ableiten können. Hier ist vornehmlich der Bereich von Intuition, Sprachgefühl und Wertung angesprochen, der sich dem Sprachfremden weitgehend verschließt. Doch sind im vorliegenden Korpus einige Fälle von semantischem Parallelismus so fragwürdig, dass sie sich auch dem Sprachfremden geradezu aufdrängen, und dies nicht zuletzt, weil er hier bekannte semantische Strukturen identifizieren kann. Dies gilt vor allem in der Gruppe der Paradoxa, aber auch in einer Reihe weiterer Textbeispiele lassen sich die Assoziationen nachvollziehen, auf die es der semantische Parallelismus anregt. Man vergleiche dazu die folgende Auswahl von Kollokationen von Begriffen. Matsuku, CD, Geschäftigkeit, Unlass versus Fliege. Ngawaka, Ewe, Flusslauf, Mündung. Yake Boko, Eichhörnchen, das kluge Fabeltier, Hyäne, das dumme Fabeltier. Mama Mada, Mutter, Nebenfrau des Vaters, Stiefmutter. Tuwaka Ogo, das Schaf ist dumm, Ziege ist klug. Mufaka Hunu, Kanuli, Inhaber des Salzmonopols, das Salz selbst. Seda Gewa Reha, Makona La Tsana, schöne Kleider, dummer Verstand. Ga Gewa Celi, Brustansatz, Oberteil des Rumpfes, Hüftung. Es geht immer so weiter. Gewasa Malada Gewe, eine bekannte Schöne, versus ihr Verehrer. Fgafe Melga, schwarzhäuptige Kobra, Buschra. Masala Dalan, gebrechlicher Krüppel, aber kerngesund. Mderi, Ewe, Gesäß oder Mund. Und so weiter. Nach dem, was wir einschränkend als expliziten semantischen Parallelismus bezeichnen können, ist das besondere Merkmal von Sprachkunstwerken vom Gewahrer-Typus, deren impliziter semantischer Parallelismus, der das Verhältnis von Sachsphäre gegenüber Bildsphäre betrifft. Wir erinnern uns, dass das Gleichnishafte dieses Literaturgenres sich aus dem unmittelbaren Bezug der Äußerung auf vorangegangenes verbales oder nichtverbales Verhalten ergibt. Hier wird das Prinzip der Äquivalenz im neuen Sinne greifbar, als Treffsicherheit, Scharfsinn, Ironie oder Grotesk.
Thank you.
features, genocide, perpetrated by German troops against the Hereros and, to a lesser extent, Nama people. German settlers demanding land and assuming racial privilege produced a tense situation.
letzten drei der vier Silben ein identisches tonematisches Muster auf. Ich versuche es mal. Während die chinesische Verskunst auf eine besondere Spielart des quantitativen Verses erscheint, ist der Vers der Ethik-Rätsel mit dem gebräuchlichen akzentuierenden Vers durch eine Gegenüberstellung von zwei Graden der Hervorhebung, Betonung oder Höhe des vokalischen Tons verbunden. Zitat, Seite 300, Seite 113. Natürlich ist das Korpus von 62 Einheiten zu wenig umfangreich, als dass sich von der Quantität her gültige Aussagen zum tonalen Vers im Laman machen ließen. Außerdem hat über Fragen vom Versbau und über Phonetik während meiner Feldforschung keine Beratung mit Laman-Sprechern stattgefunden, da mir die Bedeutung dieser Fragen erst später zu bewusst sein kann. Die Verwendung des Versbegriffs für Genres der oralen Literatur der Laman steht zudem entgegen, dass es sich bei Wattwara-Sprachkunst um einzeilige Äußerungen handelt. Dies gilt vergleichbar auch für das Genre der einfachen Rätsel, die den Untersuchungsgegenstand des dritten Teiles dieser Studie ausmachen. Nichtsdestoweniger können wir jedoch eine Reihe von strukturellen Regelmäßigkeiten beobachten, die den Schluss nahelegen, dass die syntaktische Manipulation von Sequenzen durchaus motiviert sein kann durch den Wunsch nach Herstellung eutonetischer Strukturen.
Oh, I'm gonna go. Limited.
Why were you doing this?
Someone could stand. left or right,
see,
or below.
Why do you want to come in and say the door?
What do I do now? I mean,
not
my
sure.
Friend
is still
at work.
Inside.
He doesn't come at this time.
Inside, behind the door.
Right.
And he should ring the bell at this time.
Somewhere
so I'm glad I've got this body, but...
And, you know, this way is the whole...
If I open the door now, I
yes.
still don't know. Because
yes.
I can't feed somebody.
Yes.
Okay. I better think about it again.
Better think about it again.
Really thinking. Thinking.
Okay. I've got this German door, I've got the spy, but I've been thinking. I've been thinking, and I think this is very, very stupid. I've got the spy, and I can't see who it is, and the doorbell rang, so obviously someone wants to get in touch with me.
Yeah.
Well, yes, so I think I have to decide what I'm going to do. Open the
hurry
door.
Hurry up, please.
Or not.
I think we should add a locker, just in case.
I think we still have time.
Sounds very scary.
Plenty of time.
You can't
stay inside.
Plenty
of
time.
But
you
say on
here,
you can't have enough lockers.
Oh, I'm still thinking.
What the?
I'm still thinking.
There's plenty of time.
I'm getting angry. I've been here in my house. It was all fine. I was just explaining you a German door. And then the doorbell rang, and now I don't know what to do.
Of course. It's very confusing.
Okay. This has taken a lot of time to make a decision. I'm going to open the door now.
Thank you.
sons of farmers, thus searching the land and disrupting settlements. Thus, in turn, it comes such as that on Death Island, where a scientist called Dr. Bofinger was apparently at liberty to experiment on humans.
I'm Thank you. Thank you.
Egyptian order, all hilaros, whether man, woman, or child, were to be killed. An orgy of looting, torture, and massacre followed. To read the records is exactly like reading the accounts of the obliteration of Poland, except that the Germans had not gas chambers then.
Europa hat den Afrikanern viele Segnungen gebracht. Ruhe und Ordnung. Gerechtigkeitspflege. Aufhören der endlosen Stammesfäden. Krankheitsbekämpfung. Hygiene. Schulwesen und europäische Studien.
Experimental live radio.
which is inspired by our research on the colonial history of Hamburg. And we would like to invite you to the opening of the of an exhibition we will make in relation to this workshop. It is happening within the frame of Radikal Unsichtbar, Center for Collective Learning and Radical Listening. The exhibition will take place tomorrow in Gängeviertel, in Raum links rechts. We will open the doors at 7 o'clock in the evening, and at 8 o'clock in the evening, there will be an artist talk with the artist, Hanan Benamar, who has been conducting this workshop. And there will be an exhibition by Claudia Lummel-Schitz, who will make the performative installation piece, Shamanic Cultivation Camp. Now, Hanan will read a little bit of the text about the workshop.
During the workshop, Nomen Radu, the participants were invited to investigate a series of words taken from the work and title of Progress Days of Barba. Action, silence, ego, emptiness, failure, violence, doubt, chaos, ritual, order, nomenclature, and taboo. Each word is entitling a paragrapher and are divided between four different chapters: desire, strength, metamorphosis, and hospitality. Taking the structure of this writing in process, writing in progress, the workshop was an attempt to work creatively through the plethora of possibilities that offered these words and link them to the colonial history of Germany and more specifically Hamburg. The title of the workshop is a neologism of the words Nomen and Natur, crossing out words with the word Nomen. The horizontal line of erasure brings us back to the theme of these landscapes central in my work. The Museum of Anthropology of Hamburg has been hosting parts of the workshop by making accessible the collection of archived and permanent exhibitions.
The history of the collection will be researched and sold. And then we also tell the composer about it.
Yeah.
listeners, 10 seconds, and then we're off there.
Thanks to the participants.
See you at the opening
tomorrow.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's it.
Na, das ist das einzige Problem.
Good work.
Good construction.
Yes,
yeah.
Was he warned?
Just laugh.
He's
been
enjoying
that.